The hunt is on. Kate secretly hides copies of new book around UK. Can you find one? Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, stepped out of Kensington Palace to celebrate the launch of the Hold Still book. Kate has taken part in the Book Fairies initiative to mark the launch of the Hold Still book, which goes on sale today. The Duchess of Cambridge was filmed placing a copy of the Hold Still book near a statue of Queen Victoria in London for royal fans to find and collect. The book, which gathered the 100 pictures taken by the finalists of the Hold Still contest, also has a letter from the Duchess tucked inside. The Book Fairies initiative sees readers around the world hiding books for people to find, read and leave for someone else. Kensington Palace revealed the Duchess isn't the only person to have hidden a copy of the newly launched book in plain sight. Upon sharing Kate's clip, the royal household said, "Let the search begin. We've joined at the _ Book Fairies for the day to share copies of Hold Still around the UK with you. Each copy is adorned with a gold Book Fairy sticker, gold ribbon, and has a letter from the Duchess tucked inside. Hashtags Book Fairies. To make this activity even more special, Book Fairies, the Hold Still judges and participants of the final 100 images are leaving copies at places that gave them hope during the lockdown. This special book documenting the unique collection of photographs goes on sale today. In the clip, Kate is seen walking towards the statue in a long red dress and placing the book. The idea to make the launch more special by taking part in the Book Fairies initiative sent royal fans into a frenzy. One commented on Kensington Palace's tweet saying, "What a marvelous idea. Love this." Another said, "This project just keeps getting better and better. Very happy for the lucky passerby who finds one. Any chance the Book Fairy has made her way to Edinburgh?" And a third added, "I would get crazy if I found a copy." The book, the sale of which will be split between mental health charity Mind and one of Kate's patronages, the National Portrait Gallery, also presents an introduction penned by Kate. She wrote, "When we look back at the COVID-19 pandemic in decades to come, we will think of the challenges we all faced, the loved ones we lost, the extended isolation from our families and friends and the strain placed on our key workers. But we will also remember the positives, the incredible acts of kindness, the helpers and heroes who emerged from all walks of life, and how together we adapted to a new normal." She continued, "Through Hold Still, I wanted to use the power of photography to create a lasting record of what we were all experiencing, to capture individuals' stories and document significant moments for families and communities as we lived through the pandemic." The book launch comes exactly 1 year after Kate launched the Hold Still Photography Contest in collaboration with the National Portrait Gallery. The Duchess' aim was to portray life in Britain during the first national lockdown. Out of the thousands of pictures submitted, a panel of judges handpicked 100 finalists, included in the book. These pictures were also displayed across the country on billboards. As it was revealed yesterday, Kate has got in touch with a number of finalists in autumn 2020. The first full video released on the Cambridge's new YouTube channel is a phone call between the Duchess and 4-year-old Mila, the subject of Shielding Mila, one of the 100 finalists. In the photograph, snapped by Mila's mum Linda, the child looks at her dad through the window. As explained to the Duchess during the phone call, Mila's family took the difficult decision to split in the run-up to the first national lockdown to protect their youngest daughter, who was undergoing chemotherapy. Thank you. One of the 100 finalists. In the photograph, snapped by Mila's mum Linda, the child looks at her dad through the window. As explained to the Duchess during the phone call, Mila's family took the difficult decision to split in the run-up to the first national lockdown to protect their youngest daughter, who was undergoing chemotherapy.